11 money skills you should know. Just having money left over at the end of each month, is it going to make you rich? Yes. You should live within your means such that you're not flat broke before your next paycheck comes in, but that's only the first step on your road to wealth. What's more important is the level of money skills you have. The more skills you have, the more likely you are to boost your finances and live the life you've always wanted. And doing this begins with changing the way you think about money. If you don't change the way you think about money, you'll never have enough, no matter how much you make. In today's video, we are going to be looking at 11 money skills you should know. Learning and understanding these skills will revolutionize the way you look at money, so you can make moves on your wealth journey. Number one, learn the difference between assets and liabilities. The default setting of most people when they begin to make a little more money is to get a better car or some other fancy possessions. But that's not wealth. Wealth is built by investing in valuable financial assets. And if you want to acquire physical possessions, try to make them assets that can help make you additional money and not have high initial depreciation. In other words, before you buy that Lambo with hopes it will gain resale value down the road, consider the maintenance, insurance, and fuel costs associated with owning that kind of vehicle. Not to mention the average 20 to 30% price reduction a year after you drive it off the lot. If, on the other hand, you invest in something that yields you high interest or monthly cash flow instead, like a rental property in a desirable area, that's a better use of your money. Such investments, referred to as assets, can help you build wealth in the long term as they increase in value with time, and you can normally cash out for more money in the future than you initially invested. Now let's talk liabilities. Basically, anything that puts you in debt or costs you money is a liability. So it could be the Lambo we talked about earlier, student loans, a home loan, or credit cards. Even your phone and lease agreement are liabilities. Now, to figure out how wealthy you actually are, try adding up the value of your assets, the cash flow they produce, and your savings, and then subtracting your liabilities. Then, see how long you can survive without earning any more money. The longer that time is, the wealthier you truly are. Number two. Saving won't make you rich. The second lesson you must understand about money is there's no rich person on earth who got there by strictly saving money. You simply can't save your way into becoming a millionaire. Unless, of course, you are already a millionaire who can just deposit the money, in which case you'd have to be a millionaire first. So in other words, we're back to where we started. Saving money isn't bad, and that's not what this point is trying to suggest. But saving money and just hoping that one day you'll save enough to retire wealthy? That's where the problem is. You should always save money, but it should be with the intention to turn that cash into wealth. Still, saved cash has its uses. Number one, if anything ever happens to your regular income, having 3 to 6 months of your living expenses saved up in liquid cash would really come in handy. You'd be able to manage until you got back on your feet, and this is highly recommended before investing large amounts of money elsewhere. Number two, saved cash means more investment opportunities become available to you. So, say a business opportunity comes up or there's an opportunity to invest in real estate, some opportunities are only able to be purchased with cash. If you have it, you'd be able to negotiate a better deal or lock down the investment and start to build your portfolio. So, saving isn't bad, but saving for the sake of saving isn't the best way to build wealth. Number three, make taxes work for you. It's usually the case that the less you earn, the more you dread taxes, and the more taxes you pay. The rich, on the other hand, have figured out how to make taxes work for them, so they don't have to fear the tax man. If you want to start making taxes work for you, then you need to understand how taxes work in your country. Learn about tax incentives, and figure out how you can use them to protect your funds. Usually, there are some nice tax benefits you can enjoy for investing towards your retirement. On the other hand, you pay a lot of tax just by leaving your money lying dormant in a savings account. In the same vein, keeping your property in a trust might be more beneficial tax-wise than owning it as an individual. These tax advantages can add up, and you should consider speaking to a certified tax professional about how you can leverage the tax code to your advantage. Number four, learn the principle of how OPM, or other people's money, works. You can't be scared of debt and expect to be wealthy in life. We've been taught to fear debt, and sure, it's a good thing. You shouldn't be going into debt or putting yourself on a payment plan to get those new sneakers. But many times, if you're going to scale up your business operations to a level where it brings in a much higher return, you're going to need to get loans at a manageable interest rate. If you're able to purchase the needed machinery or upgrades, you can charge more, or you could provide faster services to your customers, which could bring you more money. But a word of caution, before going to investors or a bank for a loan, have your financials in order and make sure that you can cover your debt whether or not your business predictions go as planned. With that said, we move to skill number 5. The problem is with how much you earn, not necessarily how much you spend. Let's dive into that. Oftentimes, not having enough is not a matter of cutting back on expenses. More times than not, the solution is to earn more. Of course, no one is saying you should live above your means, but it's much better to try to look for ways to earn more money than to simply try to cut down on your expenses. This could come through getting a raise at your job, adding a side hustle, changing jobs, or boosting productivity at your business. The point is that you need to train your mind to operate with an abundance mindset rather than one of scarcity. You need to be open to opportunities around you and ready to move on them when they are presented. Number 6, you want to know your dollar needs. We've established that earning more money is important if we're going to have enough to live on and invest. Now, you need to know just how much money you actually need. This way, you are more careful with how you spend your money once you start earning more of it. The good thing is that most banking apps have the option of labeling your expenses. With this information, you can begin seeing just how much you spend on each area of your life and correct overages. Number 7, and this one is super important, have a retirement plan. The sooner you're able to set up your retirement fund, the earlier you can retire. It's that straightforward. In most countries, everyone that works is entitled to some form of retirement benefit. In the US, that's what is called your 401k or 403b. For some, it's sufficient, but for others, it might not be. If you belong to the second group, then explore other private options such as a Roth IRA. The good thing is that investing toward your retirement comes with a lot of initial tax benefits, but don't confuse tax deferred with tax free. A common misunderstanding is that money placed into a traditional 401k or 403b plan is tax-free. While it does lower your income tax in the year you make the investment, you will have to pay taxes on the money you withdraw from the account during retirement. This is why some prefer a Roth IRA, where the taxes are paid upfront. Once you retire, investments in a Roth IRA can be withdrawn with no taxes because they've already been paid. So, don't be afraid to explore other private retirement fund options. Typically, these long-term investments work based on compounding interest. So, the earlier you start planning toward your retirement, the more you'll earn long-term, which leads us to our next skill. Number 8, understanding compounding. Compounding is one of the pillars used to build long-term wealth. It has no barrier to entry, and anyone can gain from participating in compounding investments. For instance, if a 25-year-old puts $100 per month into a Roth IRA and is able to earn a 12% annual return, they will retire at 65 with over $1 million. But if that person waited until they were 35 to begin investing that same $100 per month, they would only have $300,000 at retirement, costing them $700,000. This is the power of compounding and one of the biggest money secrets the wealthy use. Number 9, learn how to protect your money. You've definitely heard people advising you to diversify your investments, and this principle has been around for centuries. Because it is not how much you make, but how much you keep that matters. But while these are real risks, a bigger threat to your wealth is actually having all your eggs in one basket. If the economy, Bitcoin, or the housing market tanks, inflation hits, or there's a crisis like the one that hit the world in 2020, you'll be left hanging in limbo. So, consider diversifying your investments into various forms, limiting your risk, if one area takes a nosedive. Number 10, look for ways to make passive income. Take a look at your average day right now. How much time do you have to spend in a day to earn what you currently make? To make more money, you would need a raise, to switch jobs, move to a new city, or work overtime. This is what we call trading time for money. It's a necessary evil, whether you work for someone else or own your own business. But the truth is, if you can take some of the money you make from your normal work and invest it in the right places, your money can make you more money. And sometimes, the step you need to take is as little as putting some spare change in an interest-bearing account. Investing in dividend stocks, real estate, startups, crypto, or even a friend's business can have your money growing like the rich and famous. Finally, number 11, have a wealth-building plan. Benjamin Franklin once said, "If you fail to plan, you are planning to fail." And truer words have never been said when it comes to building your wealth. If you don't know where your money is going, you can't make decisions on how to best use it. Once you know where your money is going, you can then create your wealth plan on how to invest it. Some recommend that you save the first hour from each workday for investing, with others like Elizabeth Warren recommending a 50-30-20 plan, with 50% going into your needs, 30% going into your wants, and 20% goes to investing. There is no right or wrong answer here, and you need to decide what works best for you based on your current financial situation and desired future wealth. The key is to have a plan and sticking to it. Let us know which tip you found the most helpful in the comments. Also, make sure to leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it, and while you're at it, click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you know when we drop new content. So until next time, warriors, live well and focus on your wealth. We will see you in the next video.